Well, it goes without saying, this year was a tough one for the class of 2020. And as we continue to battle with the pandemic into the new year, the class of 2021 may face some difficulties as well. Former president of Brandeis University and current Georgetown Law lecturer Frederick Lawrence joins me now with what students and parents need to know about the challenges and opportunities that lie ahead. Good morning to you. Thank you so much for joining us.
Good morning. Good to be with you.
Of course. Before we get into the challenges and opportunities, I want to talk about how education just in general will look different moving forward.
You know, to a certain extent, what happened last spring was astonishing. Colleges and universities tend to evolve fairly slowly over the decades, over the centuries. And then all of a sudden in March, like on a dime, the entire industry turned over and you had schools delivering their education at a distance. So that's going to change things forever. I don't mean that all schools are going to wind up going into a virtual setting. I just mean that that opportunity is going to be available. I'm sorry, speaking of virtual, I'm having a little trouble with my camera here.
We can hear you okay.
I remember my very first class at Georgetown a couple of years ago. It was a blizzard, so we had to cancel the class. That'll never happen again. We'll just go to Zoom when that happens. So yeah. I think that will change. I think the cost structure of universities will change. We can talk about that a little more in a second. Mm-hmm. So there will be changes. Having said all of that, I would expect we're talking about not whether, but when we return to something that looks very much like what we're used to, with the vast majority of our students in the United States still taking courses on campus and most of them living on campus. Mm.
And Frederick, you mentioned it there, the cost. You know, the stimulus bill, which was just signed into law, provides over $20 billion for higher education, but the total pandemic cost for universities in terms of lost revenue is more than $120 billion. So that's a pretty significant shortfall. What does that mean for students in general, but especially low-income students?
Well, it's a great question, because low-income students will always feel the pinch of this most. Schools that don't have resources will not be able to provide money for lower-income students, will have to cut back on scholarship funds. When people hear that $23 billion was in the stimulus package, that sounds like a lot of money. It is a lot of money. But that lost income, lost revenue is over $120 billion in the higher education ecosystem. I think the other thing that people have to be aware of is the multiplier effect of that. When a university or a college has to lay off the grounds crew, has to lay off the workers in the dining hall, what happens to those people? They lose their income, they can't pay their rent, they can't pay others. And so there's this cascading effect, particularly in small college towns, where they really rely on the college as the center of the economy of the town.
And really quickly here, because I want to get to the opportunities that you're going to be talking about, simply returning to campus will also be a challenge. You touched on this just slightly earlier.
Returning to campus in January, you know, more is the pity, but it's going to be a replay of August and in some ways even worse because the levels of the pandemic is worse now. So you've got all these students who came home. They traveled to all sorts of places. Schools have to bring them back very carefully, and they have to do testing. They have to do contact tracing where anything is found. They've got to isolate those students where it's found. Mm-hmm. It's an enormously complex process. It's an enormously expensive process. You know, ironically, the most affluent schools went in one of two directions. Because they had the more resources, some of them were able to bring the students back. But also precisely the schools that had the greater endowments were able to say, let's go slowly. Let's worry about the students' health. Nearly half of the schools this past semester were, in fact, open on campus. Mm-hmm. Many of them had very good stories to tell. Cornell, Tulane, Middlebury, all had good stories of very low incidence rates. But some schools had much tougher stories than that. Some of them are very famous. Notre Dame had to make a change in the middle, and there are many of others.
Okay.
It is an extremely complex and an extremely expensive process. Rochelle Walensky, who's about to be head of the Council of the Center for Disease Control in Atlanta, she's at Harvard Medical School. She told one university last fall, if you're going to test students less than twice a week for COVID, I'll save you money. Don't
and Frederick, bother. I want to get to the opportunities here because I think this is important. It's hard to imagine there would be opportunities, but what do you mean by that?
What I mean by that is that we have learned how to educate in a different way. And so we will be able to provide education long distance. We do have cost structures now that will make conferences less expensive, that will make meetings less expensive. I'm doing meetings all the time now that used to take place here in DC, where I used to fly people into Washington for meetings at Phi Beta Kappa that I run, that instead now we'll do virtually. So there'll be savings, there'll be opportunities for lower income students to be able to do an education remotely. Those are all positives. The other positive I would say is that we're going to have a new administration in Washington. We'll learn more about that as we go, of course. But there's been a lot of tension between the past administration and higher education. So there may be some good opportunities there as well.
Okay. Thank you so much, Frederick Lawrence, former president of Brandeis University and current Georgetown Law lecturer, for the eye-opening discussion. We certainly appreciate it. We know it's hard to imagine there would be opportunities ahead, but there certainly are. You just got to take advantage of them.
Got to keep looking on the optimistic side. We got a new year ahead. Let's hope for the best in it.
All right. Appreciate you.